And so it was that Atlasdam was founded some 2 centuries ago. Indeed, our fair city-state is among the longest standing on the continent of Austera. But there was another city-state with a history as long and proud as our own that came to a tragic ruin only 8 short years ago. Now, who can tell me its name? How about you, Therese?
I think it was...
Now. No need to get all flustered. There's no shame in not knowing an answer, so long as you have a desire to learn. The answer is in your textbook. Go on now, look it up.
Yes, Professor. Let's see. I believe it was Hornburg.
That is correct. Hornburg was ruled over by a royal family, said to be descended from priests of an ancient and long-forgotten religion. On the other hand, our fair Atlasdam was founded by one of the original clans that inhabited the Flatlands. Who can tell me how many clans lived in the Flatlands at the time? Your Highness?
The histories have it that 8 clans did live in the Flatlands in those days.
Correct you are, Your Highness. It was a time of great strife here in the Flatlands as the 8 clans waged a long and bitter war. Change would come when the armies of Grandport invaded these lands some 2 centuries ago. At the time, the rulers of Grandport sought to exert their influence over territories inland. Ironically, this compelled the warring tribes to put aside their differences and unite against their common foe. Oh, but look at the time. We'll pick up where we left off next time. Don't forget to read chapters 3 and 4 before our next lecture. And be prepared to answer questions on any of the material within.
Yes, Professor.
Thank you for another most stimulating lecture, Professor Albright.
Hello?
Splendid! Your Highness.
The truth of the matter is...
But of course!
Indeed.
Very astute of you. The truth is, with pleasure.
Why, thank you.
Indeed. Ah! Good day.
Farewell.
Ah, Therese. Yes? Do you have a question for me?
No.
It's me, Cyrus.
I see.
With pleasure.
I see.
Many thanks. What have we here? An interesting dilemma.
Professor Albright!
The truth is,
I see.
Many thanks. Cyrus Albright, by your request, sir.
Do enter. My apologies for summoning you on such short notice.
How might I be of assistance, Headmaster?
That treatise on arcane studies you published. What in the gods' names were you thinking?
Sir? I do believe I made my hypothesis perfectly clear.
I'm not talking about your hypothesis. You went out of your way to cite one of the texts in our special archives. The knowledge housed in those tomes is the Royal Academy's greatest treasure. It is not to be divulged to the public at your whim. Laying it bare in one of your silly papers is out of the question.
I am fully aware of the value of those tomes, Headmaster. It is for that very reason I would share the knowledge with my peers.
You are to share nothing! That wisdom is for the Academy and the Academy alone!
But that goes against everything.
Enough, Cyrus!
Even my best argument is sure to fall on deaf ears. The Headmaster sees knowledge as a medal or precious stone, something to be appreciated by its rightful owner alone. Knowledge is power, and power is to be hoarded. An unfortunate attitude, indeed. My sincere apologies, Headmaster. It won't happen again. Is there anything else you need of me?
That is all. You may go. Wait. There was one last thing.
Sir?
I heard the Special Archives will be closing early today. If you have research to do there, I would do so quickly.
Good gods. It's as if he enjoys watching me suffer. Thank you for your concern, Headmaster. In that case, I'll be on my way.
Enter.
Excuse me.
What's the matter?
Can I help you?
A moment of your time.
My apologies.
Say it is not so.
Actually,
oho. Indeed.
I see.
Leave it to me.
Take care.
Time to do some research. Splendid! But of course! Oh-ho! No. Which means that... Yes. Shall we begin?
What?
Excuse me. A moment of your time. Come now.
Pah.
The truth is... Is that so?
Pah.
Just so. Say it is not so.
Thank you.
Indeed.
Actually,
I see.
Yes.
Most intriguing. Is autumn this?
I've brought Professor Albright, as asked, sir.
Good. Enter. Thank you, Lucia.
Yes, Headmaster. What can I do for you? Something tells me he's not about to offer a commendation.
Professor Albright, a most troubling report has reached my ears.
A report, sir?
An anonymous source claims that you have abused your prestigious position to enter into an illicit relationship with Her Highness the Princess.
Oh. And you believed this report, sir?
If it is untrue, then say so.
Why, it is unfounded, unsubstantiated, balderdash of the highest order!
I would like to take your words at face value, Professor, but I fear the situation is not so simple. A rumor regarding the royal family, even an unsubstantiated one such as this, is sure to spread quickly. If we do not take swift action, Princess Mary's good name could be forever sullied. That is something that simply cannot be allowed to happen. Surely you understand.
And so what do you intend to do with me, sir?
It is not an easy decision to make. Dismissing you outright would be tantamount to an admission of guilt.
If I may be so bold, Headmaster, what about a sabbatical? Professor Albright is put on extended leave, while official accounts state that he's doing fieldwork in a distant land.
What say you, Cyrus?
This way, both the Academy's reputation and your own will remain intact.
My reputation?
Do we have a problem, Professor?
Not at all, Headmaster. On the contrary, this might prove the perfect opportunity.
Opportunity? For what?
As a matter of fact, there is a matter which has piqued my interest of late. I was just wondering when I might find the time to do a bit of research in the field. I think I will set forth on a journey in search of an ancient tome that disappeared 15 years ago. Besides, if I am not permitted to share what I have learned with my peers and the public, there is little point in continuing my research here.
Is that so? Do tell, Professor. What is it that you intend to investigate?
As regards a certain tome. Now, if you will forgive me, I must begin packing for my journey. Good day to you, Headmaster.
An enigma as ever, that one.
Professor!
Oh, Therese, what is it?
I heard that you were leaving the Academy.
Then you heard true.
Professor, I'm so sorry.
I see. So you were the source of the rumor.
You knew?
Not until just this moment, when you apologized. And yet, I cannot fathom your motive. Why would you tell such a terrible lie?
You're always helping Her Highness, answering her every question. I just wanted you to pay more attention to me.
And that's why you went to the Headmaster.
Yes, but I just wanted to get you in a little trouble. I didn't think they would. I am so sorry, Professor. Can you ever forgive me?
Worry not, my dear. It just so happens that I was looking for a good excuse to go on a journey.
You were?
For some time now, I've wanted to travel the realm and see what can be learned beyond these halls. I dare say the timing couldn't have been better. You see, there's a certain matter I simply can't wait to investigate. So fret not, my girl. If for anything, you've done me a favor. Besides, I am not entirely without fault in the matter. Indeed, I have not been as attentive to you as I should. Had I realized your true intention sooner, I would not be in this position.
Professor, whatever do you...
If only I had realized how devoted you were to your studies, my dear girl.
My studies?
I have always striven to treat all my students equally. And yet, Her Highness is always eager to ask questions, and I was all too eager to answer them. In doing so, I may have given the impression that I favored her above you and the others. This was not my intention, but I am at fault all the same. Yes, if only I had seen you for the ardent and devoted young scholar that you are!
Professor... Perhaps you're not quite as sharp as I thought you were.
Yes?
Never mind.
In that case, I should be off. Pray do not shirk your studies, my girl.
Yes, Professor. Will I ever see you again?
I do not see why not, provided we both still live. Now, I must find out all I can about From the Far Reaches of Hell. My erstwhile colleague, Odette, knows more about arcane studies than anyone I know. Last I heard, she sojourned in Quarry Quest. I should begin my journey there. Now then! Anyhow, here we are.
Yes, yes, I'll be right there.
It's been some time, Odette.
Hmm?
You're still here. I guess I'm not suffering from fatigue-induced hallucinations after all.
It's me, Odette, in the flesh. Good to see you as hale and hearty as ever.
And you're as insufferable as ever, no doubt. What are you waiting for? Come in already.
Don't mind if I do. How did I know that would be your reaction?
We were practically joined at the hip back in the day. Just watching you go about was fun in and of itself. I always had a hunch you'd end up in trouble with the ladies, but to think it would happen with the princess of all people! Somehow, you've managed to exceed even my wildest expectations.
By expelling me, they hope to protect Her Highness's good name. Needless to say, there's no truth in any of this.
Of course. I'm sure it's all as you say. Highness and this Therese are just your pupils. They have no romantic interest in you in the slightest. You're something else, Cyrus. But it's a relief to find your powers of observation are as keen as ever. Well, did you come all this way just to entertain me? If so, congratulations on a job well done.
Save your congratulations for another time. I've come in search of a certain tome. Are you perchance familiar with From the Far Reaches of Hell?
A cheery title if I've ever heard one. I can tell you that it's a compendium of ancient rites and rituals. Not that I've read it myself, of course.
I know that much. I was hoping you could tell me more.
Not much more. It touches upon necromancy, I believe.
Necromancy?
Necromancy. That said, as to what extent, I know little.
Is that so?
Give me a break.
A hole.
Naturally.
most intriguing.
Great.
As you wish.
I see.
Now then. Thusly. Aha! Most intriguing. What have we here? What in the... It couldn't be. Preposterous! Why, I'll be...
And who might you be?
Just a scholar of no particular repute. I was passing through and could not help but notice these odd gemstones. Are they perhaps your work? And these strange glyphs, are they not runes of High Hornbergian?
Are they now?
The tomes of ancient Hornberg were lost long ago. No ordinary scholar would be privy to this knowledge. But how could any self-respecting academic perform such horrors?
Ho ho! Seems you're more of a scholar than you give yourself credit for.
They still live, yes? If you know what's best for you, you'll free them at once.
Well, since you asked so nicely... No, I think not. A shame. If only you hadn't come poking around in my secrets. I wouldn't have minded picking your brain. Now I'll have to settle for sucking your blood!
What in the... Aha! Are you okay? Excuse me. Come now. Now then. The truth is...
What was that?
Thusly.
Mm-hmm.
Indeed. You have my gratitude. Aha! Which means that... Yes.
I see. You're still here.
I am, but not a moment longer. Thank you for everything, Odette. I am in your... debt.
You helped out a little here. What say we call it even? Be safe, Cyrus. I have a hunch you're poking around in something far more sinister than either of us can imagine.
I am well aware of the danger. I will exercise due caution.
Due caution? I'll believe it once you quit diving headfirst into whatever you think smells of mystery.
A man cannot so easily change his God-given disposition.
You said it was 15 years ago that the tome was stolen.
That I did. What of it?
As you may recall, the then headmaster of the academy died under mysterious circumstances that very same year.
And you believe the two incidents are connected somehow?
No, I just like spouting valedictory trivia. But now that you mention it, the disorder following the incident would offer a convenient opportunity to misappropriate an article from the archives, wouldn't you say?
Your insight is invaluable and appreciated. I will keep this in mind.
I mean it, Cyrus. Be careful out there.
I will, and I'll return as soon as I get to the bottom of this. You have my word.
I'll be waiting with bells on.
Mm-hmm. Now then. Well, excuse me.
My apologies.
A moment of your time.
Be gone with you.
Excuse me.
Oh.
But of course! Thusly. Yes. Now then. Many thanks.
Listen. In truth,
What in the...
After that...
It couldn't be.
Yes. Ah, yes. In truth...
Is that so?
Yes. Yes.
Leave it to me.
You have my thanks.
Come now.
Huh.
Just so.
Call me Lucia.
Greetings.
I apologize. In truth.
Why, I'll be...
Yes.
Indeed.
Correct.
Yes. I see.
Correct.
Hmm. Shall we begin?
Thank you.
Is that so? Where? What is this place?
Ah, Professor Albright. I apologize for this little ruse.
I'd recognize that voice anywhere. So, we meet again, Headmaster Yvonne.
When I heard you were looking into from the far reaches of hell, I knew your search would lead you here. And sure enough, you didn't disappoint me. Your mind is every bit as sharp as I thought it was.
You sent Lucia to keep an eye on me.
What a shame, my dear boy. A thirst for knowledge like yours would be such a terrible thing to waste. So, what do you say? Apprentice yourself to me, and I will overlook your little trespasses.
How kind of you. I refuse. I am, shall we say, philosophically opposed to your stance on knowledge. I believe that knowledge should be shared, not hoarded for one's personal gain.
I thought you'd say as much. Most unfortunate, Cyrus. Most unfortunate. As you know, this is my house, and I don't get many callers these days. A smart man like you knows what this means, yes? When you starve to death here, no one will be the wiser.
What have we here? Now then!
Professor? Are you okay? Actually,
hmm?
You think you can get away with this? Therese!
Professor...
You just couldn't leave well enough alone, could you? You disappoint me, Cyrus. I took you for a more logical man.
Headmaster Yvonne. What do you intend to do with her?
The girl went poking around in my secrets. I fear she can't be allowed to live. And so I'll finish off teacher and student in one fell swoop.
You'll not lay a hand on my pupil! I'll see to that!
You seem terribly agitated, Cyrus. It's not good for the humors.
It's one of those blood crystals.
You will taste the power I summoned from the far reaches of hell!
What in the... You have my gratitude.
Thank goodness.
Awake, are you?
Yes, Professor.
Therese. I must know what you saw and heard. You'll tell me, yes?
Yes, Professor. One day I heard the headmaster talking to someone in his office. I couldn't make out the other voice, but they were talking about you. They were saying they would see you dead. And so I...
You came all the way here to warn me.
Yes, Professor.
I see. Well, Therese. As your teacher, I must scold you for your most reckless and careless actions.
I understand, Professor.
But one thing is also clear. Were it not for your actions, I would have died in that dark pit. And so, as a man, I owe you a debt of gratitude. Thank you, Therese, from the bottom of my heart. But you must promise me one thing.
What is it, Professor?
In the future, pray consult someone you can trust before embarking on such a dangerous course of action.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I did learn from the best.
I suppose you did, didn't you?
Professor, I...
I must continue my journey, but I will send letters. Yes, I'll include assignments to keep your mind sharp.
Professor.
But I think we've talked enough for the day. You should rest.
Wait, Professor! The headmaster. He said one more thing.
Hmm? What's this now?
He said that once you were out of the way, there was a place he would go.
Intriguing. And where might that be, pray tell? I appreciate your concern, but I will go there. I must. In a way, we are not so different, the headmaster and I.
Professor...
That unquenchable thirst for knowledge, bordering almost on obsession. And yet, our philosophies regarding the ultimate purpose of knowledge could not be more different. The headmaster used his position and prestige to hoard knowledge for his own foul ends. As an academic, I cannot forgive this. Knowledge is for one and all. We inherit the knowledge of our ancestors and pass it on to those who follow us. Only then is its true value realized. Headmaster Yvonne believed true knowledge should begin and end with him. He was wrong. Always remember this, Therese. Knowledge is a bounty to be shared by all.
A bounty?
The more of us that possess true knowledge, the richer we all become. Those who seek knowledge must never forget this. That is what I believe. And those who would use their knowledge for nefarious ends must be stopped.
So, it would be wrong of me to keep this to myself. The headmaster said he was headed to the town of Duskbarrow.
I see. Thank you, Therese. Do not worry. Your teacher will not make the same mistake twice. When I act, I will exercise due caution.
I can believe you this time.
Please do, my dear girl.
If you say so, then I shall see you when you return.
You have my word. I will arrange for someone to look after you until your strength returns. Duskbarrow. Whatever did the headmaster seek there? Judging from his transformation to that dreadful beast, the power he obtained was an unholy one indeed. Is it possible that the tome holds not only the secrets to death, but new forms of life? And yet, I find it hard to believe that transforming himself into a demon was the headmaster's ultimate goal. After all, did he not say he was betrayed? And the original copy of the tome is still nowhere to be found. So many questions remain. But now I know where I can find the answers. On to Duskbarrow, and whatever dark secrets await me there. Time to do some research. Aha! Aha! Thank you.
here? No.
Professor, you truly are every bit as brilliant as old Yvonne said.
I did not come here for false flattery.
Oh, but I was being quite sincere. A shame the purport eludes your grasp.
To think you were the one pulling the strings. The headmaster was merely your puppet all along.
Very astute. Yes, it was I who maneuvered to install him in that position in the first place. To my dismay, he had a willful streak that got in the way.
One might say the fault lies in the person who chose him for the task.
One might say that, yes. Now, let us proceed to the matter at hand. Your search for the original copy of From the Far Reaches of Hell has miraculously led you to me. In finding me, you have displayed some measure of knowledge and acumen. More than anything, you have shown a pure and unrelenting passion for seeking out the truth. I hold that particular quality in the highest regard. What say you, Cyrus? Will you join me in my research?
Ridiculous! If that is a jape, it is a poor one.
A jape? What a curious reaction from a scholar like yourself. The wall paintings in this place, did they not pique your interest? Did your heart not race when you saw the countless lost tomes in my study?
To say I was not intrigued would be a lie.
Of course you were. Any true scholar would feel the same. I must unravel these mysteries. I must have the answers. Your mind, no, your very soul burns with an all-consuming desire to know. That is what separates you from the rest, Cyrus. We are true seekers of knowledge, you and I. Together, we can unlock all the secrets behind our world.
I'll pass.
How can you refuse? You covet the mysteries of the universe. You yearn to know the truth.
Surely you can stand shoulder to shoulder with me!
That's it exactly.
What? What is it?
Surely you. I take issue with your solicitation. You don't care who you use in your schemes. What of Headmaster Yvonne?
Don't be ridiculous. He was devoid of the passion you have. He was nothing but a pawn to the end, incapable of envisioning an ultimate goal.
On what grounds do you base that assumption? Can a man not grow his mind? If you found him wanting, why did you not teach him?
Teach him?
Take him on as your pupil. Impart your vast knowledge, that he might one day be your peer.
Preposterous! You speak the impossible. Mediocrity is as mediocrity does. Knowledgeable as he was, his own actions prevented him from ever approaching genius.
A genius such as yourself must understand this.
There's where you and I differ. I haven't given up on mediocrity. As scholars, we learn from the past to better understand the present and pass our knowledge on to the future. What do you mean to do with the knowledge you amass, the secrets you unravel? Carry them to your grave, content they are inscrutable to all who do not possess your genius. You would call them simpletons, fools, feeble minds. I say it is you who lacks the ability to teach and inspire.
Ugh.
A true scholar does not look down on others for what they do or do not know. Those who know impart knowledge to those who do not. If something is wrong, those who know the answer correct it. The process repeats, bringing us closer and closer to enlightenment. I teach my students with the expectation that one day they will surpass me. I long for the day when I will have the chance to learn from them.
Enough!
I've given you plenty of opportunities to make a move. Any move. But clearly we are going nowhere fast. If you would rather die without discovering the truth, so be it. I have already synthesized a perfect blood crystal, precisely as detailed in the original tome. With it, I will cast off the shackles of humanity. A human can only learn so much in its short lifetime. I will gain the time, the power, to understand everything. You may be a fool, but to show no hard feelings, you can participate in an empirical analysis of my newfound power.
If believing in the future makes one a fool, then call me a proud fool. But know this. When I emerge victorious, I will unravel the secrets of that tome and arrive at my own answer. Let this be a lesson to you. The future of mankind is bright.
No! There is so much more I must learn.
Mm-hmm. A hole. Now then! But of course! But of course! Indeed! Indeed. Not exactly. Thusly. Yes.
Professor! Professor!
Over here, Therese!
That stack of books seems to get bigger every time I see you.
And I'll need twice again as many to have any hope of translating this ancient tome.
Twice as many?
fascinating, is it not? A traditional fairy tale from a certain region mentioned a gate of sorts. And I could not help but notice a parallel to the mural I found.
I see. Hence, these books on local folklore?
Just so. Considering your subject from all possible angles is a fundamental principle of scholarly research. But I forget myself. Might I surmise that you've come here to inform me that it's time for class?
Yes.
You're late, Professor.
Pray forgive me, Your Highness. Very well then, my students. Let us begin. To quote the words of one Susanna Grotoff, author of Knowledge is Light. The pursuit of knowledge is a journey with no destination. As long as people live, there is always something to learn. And so we learn, we record, we speak. Points connect, thus forming our history, our agency, our identity. This world we live in is not for or of any one individual, and neither is knowledge. And so I write and speak of all that I learned, to plant seeds of knowledge that will be harvested by those who follow me. To you who have found my writings, read well these words, that they may help you build a bridge to a brighter future.